Welcome back to the VIVE Mars tutorial. In this video, we'll cover important considerations for camera calibration. Please download the latest version on the VIVE Mars website. This update includes performance optimizations and introduces reference grid lines, improving user experience during the calibration process. Before starting the calibration, it's important to set up your environment properly. If you only have two base stations, consider positioning them as shown in the image, ensuring that the tracking area covers the 45-degree rotation of the calibration board. If you have more than two base stations, position the calibration board in a location where all base stations can cover it. Pay attention to the angles of the base stations and ensure there are no obstructions when the calibration board is rotated. It's recommended to mount the calibration board on a tripod and place the rover on top for better results. The camera to calibration board distance can be adjusted to about 1 to 1.5 meters, depending on the focal length of the lens, to ensure the calibration board appears at the right size in the frame. Regarding lighting, avoid direct light on the calibration board that could cause reflections or shadows. You can slightly narrow the camera's aperture and increase the ISO to achieve a clear image with a good depth of field. Connect the rover on the camera to port 1. And the rover on the calibration board to port 3. Once you've confirmed that the video feed is normal and the sensor size is correctly set, you can begin the calibration process. Please note that the calibration tool only supports a 16:9 aspect ratio. If your shooting requires a 3:2 or 17:9 ratio, first, set your camera to 16:9 and enter the corresponding sensor size values in the calibration tool to accurately calibrate the lens file. While anamorphic lenses are not supported, ultra-wide and long focal lengths can present challenges during calibration. Therefore, it's advisable to choose a more standard focal length range for your lens. If you don't need to track focus during shooting and don't need to change the zoom, you can choose single focal length for calibration. If you find that the capture frame cannot cover the checkerboard during calibration, you can move the camera to continue the process. However, focus adjustments are not allowed during calibration, and you must ensure that at least 70% of the checkerboard area is captured within the frame. Once the single focal length calibration is complete, you will see the calibrated values, and you can select the desired output format to save. Whether you're using one FIS track to track focus or zoom, or two FIS tracks at the same time, you'll need to first calibrate the initial focal length before moving on to focus mapping and calibrating the next focal length. Please install FIS track, connect it to the corresponding port on the rover, and select multiple focal length. After you complete the multiple focal length calibration for the first time, the next steps will depend on how you're using your PhysTrack. If you're using two PhysTracks, both actions will be necessary. If you're using your PhysTrack to track focus, you'll need to do focus mapping. Simply rotate the focus ring and enter the corresponding parameters. Then click Done to save it. If you're using your PhysTrack to track zoom, you can move on to calibrating the next focal length. Please follow the system instructions. Adjust the focal length and ensure the focus is clear. If you want to edit the lens file for multiple focal length in the future, you can click on the calibration history in the bottom left to view past records and select the one you want to modify for adjustment. Next, we will apply the calibrated lens file to the Unreal project for review. Please ensure that both the LiveLink camera and camera calibration plugins are enabled. Then added Mars IP and port 6666 to the static endpoint in the UDP settings and set the unicast endpoint to the PC's own IP, ensuring that LiveLink's message bus source can recognize the signal from Mars. Next, find the Cine camera actor and add the LiveLink controller component. If you are using a version of Unreal earlier than 5.0, you can find the lens file option under the camera roll in the LiveLink controller and select the desired lens file. After importing the lens file, we first select a single focal length lens file. Once the lens file is applied, you will see the perspective of the Cine camera actor change accordingly. Next, switch to a lens file with multiple focal lengths, and when zooming and focusing, the image should adjust as well, indicating that the calibrated lens file is functioning correctly. Also, please make sure that the values displayed for the lens file in Unreal correspond to the focal length of the lens you are using in order to achieve the correct results. If you are using Unreal version 5.1 or above, please add the lens as a separate component. Select the lens file here, check the relevant settings, and ensure that the image changes with zooming and focusing. If you often run into error messages or unknown failures during the calibration process, try referring to the tips mentioned in the video to make adjustments. We hope this video provides a clear explanation of how to use the calibration tool and is helpful to all viewers. Thank you.